Hello, Gnatterstorms! It's finally here! The day where I get to lose my creationist video virginity. Like a lot of people, I want my first time to be something special. And I think I found the person to make it just that. Gnatterstorms, I want you to meet the Cubbymo. He's been reading reports. He also sounds like he's doing his video on sulfur hexafluoride.
Whenever I look at reports of scientific discoveries that contradicts evolution, my head starts to spin whenever I see evolutionists scramble for an explanation, no matter how oxymoronic the explanation really is.
Yeah, this is gonna be dumb.
Scientists have recently discovered sulfur bacteria they allege to be about 2 billion years old that has remained unchanged to modern sulfur bacteria found in mud off the coast of Chile. But despite this complete lack of change over all this time, which is what they claim evolution is,
that's not a claim, that's pretty much exactly how the word evolution is defined.
It somehow still supports Charles Darwin's theory of evolution, because they claim, seemingly without a doubt in their mind, that an organism is not supposed to change if the physical or biological environment doesn't change.
And they would be absolutely right. Organisms generally don't evolve much when the selection pressures imposed on them by the biophysical environment remain the same, provided that the organisms are already well adapted to said environment, of course.
Now, I spent at least 10 minutes trying to wrap my head around this statement.
Clearly that wasn't long enough.
Because they claim that if the organisms did change, yet the environment did not, that would have shown that their understanding of Darwinism was seriously flawed. Now, they continue to make statements like this, despite the numerous organisms that have been found over the last few years, showing that an organism's development over time, as they define change, which is change from one kind to another.
No, that's how you define it. Evolutionary biologists that you haven't made out of straw don't use the vague language of creationists. In biology, evolution is typically defined as change in allele frequencies within populations over successive generations.
Really has little to do with the environment, such as the tadpole shrimp and the horsehead crab.
He means the horseshoe crab, which are quite literally bloody interesting creatures, by the way.
Two creatures that, despite hundreds of millions of years worth of environmental changes, remain virtually the same to this day. They've been through thick and thin in numerous catastrophes, yet they remain unchanged.
I know you think you've got some kind of gotcha argument, but really you're just showing how poor your reading comprehension is. And it is amazingly bad. Neither the tadpole shrimp nor the horseshoe crab has remained unchanged over millions of years, despite changes to the world around them. Something that the articles you've been reading make quite clear. In fact, the tadpole shrimp article is literally about how it turns out they have evolved if you look at the DNA. Seriously, how did you miss that? It even says it in the quote you showed. And in the horseshoe crab article, it outright states that the fossil species is more primitive than the extant one. No change, my green wobbly ass. When the morphology of these two orders hasn't changed a whole lot compared to other branches of the tree of life, it's because it hasn't needed to. Their body plans are already well adapted to the niches they've been occupying for millions of years.
You have drug-resistant bacteria that for a long time was taught in school to be the result of Darwinian natural selection. That the fittest and most resistant bacteria survives and passes on its genes based on environmental factors.
What the fuck do you mean for a long time? That's still being taught in school. Because, and now this is just a wild guess, it's true. Antibiotic compounds select for bacteria resistant to that compound because those that aren't die. What part of that do you have a problem with again?
In fact, it has nothing at all to do with Darwinism or any kind of antibiotic treatment whatsoever. Because a drug-resistant bacteria, allegedly more than 4 million years old, was recently found in a cave in New Mexico about 3 years ago, with no contact with the outside world at all. Because of this, it is suggested that antibiotic resistance is in fact hardwired into the bacteria, meaning that it was designed that way from the start.
You are as honest as fuck, or denser than plutonium. Apparently my money is on both. As mentioned in the article, antibiotics likely were involved in the cave bacteria developing resistance. It just wasn't the ones made by us, but rather naturally occurring ones. When it says that antibiotic resistance is hardwired into bacteria, it's talking about how, over possibly billions of years, the naturally occurring antibiotics promoted the evolution of bacteria, which required fewer mutations in order to become resistant.
Now I could go on, but it matters not.
I'm sure you could. And yes, the ramblings of an uninformed layperson do indeed matter diddly squat in science.
Because Darwinian evolution is never wrong, despite the mountain of evidence stacked against it.
Such as? And why didn't you present those?
They are always right, so if they find anything that disproves it, it's no problem for them. They will simply twist the evidence to fit into their paradigm, into their definition of an organism's change over time.
No, it isn't a problem, because we tend to adjust our beliefs according to the evidence. Nobody's twisting any evidence, you're just incapable of understanding basic biology.
Which brings me to the reason why I made this video to begin with.
You actually had a reason for this.
We see atheists often demand we bring evidence for the giants of Genesis 6.
Which we still haven't gotten, by the way.
And for the Christians who fraternize with the enemy on a regular basis about the Word of God, I ask you why. Why are you wasting your time with these fools who boastfully profess themselves to be wise, knowing that no amount of evidence will even so much as make a dent in the armor that Satan built for them?
Why yes, Mr. Cheese, I would very much like to see your collection of novelty doorknobs.
If evolutionist groups like the Smithsonian Institute were to suddenly admit that the giants were real and even put them on display, which I believe they will eventually, do you seriously think that you would get the truth about who they really were? You're not.
And that's why Jews don't eat oysters.
And contrary to what some might think, I don't believe they destroy the remains at all. As they never destroy evidence, they only hide it. This is Satan's kingdom. So we should never expect the cold, hard truth from the father of lies.
Or from you, apparently. That got way dumber than I expected. I mean, your complete inability to understand a few fairly low-level news articles was bad enough, but then you decided to throw a conspiracy in at the end. I wasn't wrong when I said you would be the perfect person to break my creationist timing. And with those words, dear Gnatterstorms, thanks for watching.